a lot of the time, I see, you know, some indie game come up on my feed, and I'm like, oh yeah, that'd be cool. I wouldn't mind doing a video on that. But that seems like so much work to get that set up, and I'm busy with a bunch of other shit. And sometimes you see the words horror game fishing simulator in a big row on your Twitter or whatever it was I saw this on. And I go, holy shit, I have to know. Holy shit, that unlocks something in my brain. That unlocks something in my brain, me going, oh yeah, I love horror games, and I love fucking fish murder. I love an excuse to murder a bunch of fishes. Okay, that was a bit edgelordy to begin the video with, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. This is a game by Celui, S-E-L-E-W-I. I believe he's a guy from Argentina. He just did this as like a game jam thing. Believe it or not, it's not a puppet combo. I thought, like, you know, I saw a PS1 style, you know, horror game, and I immediately just went, oh, it's a puppet combo, isn't it? No, it turns out it's not. No, it's just some completely other dude. Turns out people just really like the PlayStation 1 aesthetic for like indie horror games. Crazy. So let's give this game a spin. Let's see what this game is all about. Oh yeah. Oh, look at that. Look at those fucking polygons. You can count the polygons on your hand. Give me the ore. Wazzed to move. Awesome. I can't strafe the boat. I can't strafe the boat. I can only turn the boat. I assume it's like a tank control thing, as any good PS1 game would go. But let's go. Let's go. It's time. It's time for a nice fishing trip. Okay, I freaked out when I was testing this, and I immediately assumed that like the game crashed on me when it happened. But no, it's just click the mouse. I know. I freaked out too. Game crashes are scarier than like anything else. These waters are so calm. It's good to know there is absolutely no one for miles and miles around. Finally, some peace and quiet. I've been waiting for this vacation for a long time. And there's your story. There's your setup. We're going on a lovely fishing trip. We're just going on a nice fishing trip. I can see fuck all. I have no idea where the game wants me to go. I'm just going to keep plowing forward until, like, you know, something turns up, I guess. I bet I'll find good fish in this spot. It's not like I'm luring them with my bait. They are calling me and inviting me here to a delightful fishing morning, and I'll gladly oblige. I mean, something's calling you? I understand. I understand, buddy. You don't realize that you're in a horror game yet. That's fair. Like, if we all knew, if you knew right now that you were in the middle of a horror game, that, like, you know, you wouldn't react the same. I mean, nothing. Don't worry about it. You're not in a horror game. Life isn't a horror game. I don't know what you're talking about. No, you're being ridiculous. Okay, so I click, and I chuck my line. That's close enough to a line. Yep. Yep, give me that. You got a nasty fish. Ugh. It's missing an eye. Aw, that's disappointing. Aw, this fish is used. I found a used fish. Bummer. Can I, like, exchange? You guys will still take this, right? 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 Okay, so how is the progression in this gonna... I don't seem to be able to move. The guy... I guess maybe the game just wants me to keep fishing. I don't see a lot of other options. I guess just keep fishing. I thought I heard something. I got more nasty fish. Okay, so that's the second fish that's missing an eye. I mean, you know, bummer for you guys. That is, like, the keyboard's still working, yeah? No, I'm just locked in here. I'm locked in. This game just want me to keep fishing? I mean, if you say so. I guess. Yep, more. Never stop. Okay, yeah, okay, no, it was literally just find three fish. Okay, that's easy enough. I love seeing their shiny wet scales when they are reeled out of the water. It gets me hard. What? This is almost too easy. I bet I can catch even better fish in the center of the lake. I should get further away from the shore. Yeah, okay, so, like, what was my experience fishing as a kid? Like, fuck all. I thought fishing I always thought fishing was like an inherent trait that all fathers would just know. I thought all fathers were just like born with the inherent ability to fish. And then my dad was like a mechanic. My dad was a panel beater. So like, yeah, he was the least fishing guy in the entire goddamn world. They say this lake is cursed, but it looks normal right today. Are they scared just by a little morning fog? I like the fog. I feel like the lake is hugging me inside it. I don't know why nobody wants to come here to Lake Rottonwood. It's so calm and enjoyable. Well, I mean, Rottonwood isn't like the greatest, name for a tourist trap. You know, if you're going to come up with a name, you want a bunch of tourists to come up with, how about, like, you know, Rottonwood maybe not isn't the best. Like, you know, Lake Fest Sludge isn't exactly going to call a lot of people, is it? Is it? Okay, so is the game just going to tell me when it's okay for me to, like, he just says go to the center of the lake, right? This is the spot! Something big is waiting for me deep below. Right here in this spot, I can feel it in my guts and in my skin. You can phrase that, like, way better, surely. Okay, so I thought maybe holding the button or something might make the line go further or something. Another one of these. Yeah. You got a nice looking fish. It must taste awesome. Like, I feel like you could have led with this. I feel you could have led with, oh yeah, this fish is fine. Instead of like the three fish in a row that are missing eyes. Like that could have, you know, you could have started simple and then built up. But that's just me. That's just my opinion. So yeah, my dad, he wasn't a fishing guy. I kind of tried to get him into fishing when I was like 12. But again, it was just because I was like, oh, all fathers, all dads have inherent fishing powers, right? And that turned out, no, I guess not. But I did have a brother-in-law who liked fishing. I don't think he liked me very much, though. It is part of the pleasure of fishing. You have to stay very still and silent, but you can be alone with your thoughts. A very special state of mind. I even lose track of time. I like this. But how long has it been? Seconds, minutes, even more. It's almost as if I'm not on the lake anymore. I'm holding the rod, but I'm also far away. What are you talking about, dude? Fucking stoner. Now I feel strong weight in my chest. Am I daydreaming? I never close my eyes, I'm sure. You have eyelids, right? Right? Like 99.9% of game characters don't feel the need to blink, so you never know. It was that one guy in the SCP Containment Breach. That's like the only guy in the entire world in video games who has understood the concept of, like, eyelids. But it seems to be slowly changing around me without me noticing. How much time has passed? Have I drifted away? I feel like something very bad is about to happen. Well, you did go out to a place called fucking Lake Rottonwood. I feel like shit's greener than it was a minute ago. And that looks like it's just on the edge of the fog there, but like there's it feels like there's something going on over there. So yeah. Let's just barrel forward. Only good things. Only good things can come out of there. Okay, so that's the shore. There's fuck all here. Yeah, I had a brother who was into fishing. He tried to take me fishing once, but like all I ever caught was fucking seaweed. Well, it's not my fault he threw my rod in a bunch of seaweed. It's not my fault. Oh, let's get on that praising, fellas. I mean, there's not a lot of sun out here. So praising the sun is a little difficult. Have we finally gotten to the point where like Dark Souls is like less cool to make references to? I feel like it's still kind of cool, but it's like it's wearing thin real fucking fast, right? Right, shut up. I could be a local, you don't know. I'm such a local. The Rotten Church, I can't believe my eyes. I never thought all the stories were true, and yet here I am. You sure? It's called the Rotten Church, buddy. Are you sure that you there's one to click in your head that maybe you're inside a horror game? What if you just, like, backed the boat up? Just back the boat up. Back up. I'm sure you'll find out. I'm sure you'll figure it out. Some fishermen tell stories. It is known there used to be a small village by the river here when Riverwood Lake sits today. But one stormy night, water levels start going up, and it didn't stop until the whole valley was underwater. No one's... That's a whole valley. That's fucked. It's like, are we talking like Grand Canyon size or what? I mean, that seems a little bit absurd. Yep, so I found an abandoned-ass church that, like, nobody remembers, huh? That just disappeared one night in a horrible, like, flood that killed, like, an entire small parish. Let's go in and do some fishing! That sounds like a fun idea. Let's go fishing. Oh, cool. I mean, that's telling me to stay out. I really should just listen to that shit, shouldn't I? Some say the flood was a divine punishment for the wicked acts of the villagers. Others said they worshipped the river, offering peculiar sacrifices in return for the bountiful fishing seasons. The souls of all the damned lurk in every corner. They say the only way to escape this cursed space is to gather three heads under the roof of Preacher Johansson. I need to find the three heads and bring them back. Fucking what? That's just an urban legend, huh? That everyone just passes around. Hey, just grab three heads. Grab three heads, huh? You know what? I got a better idea. I've got a way better idea. Game solved. I won the game, guys. Yep. Okay, so I didn't win the game. Okay, fine. Game. Fine. I mean, if I war thug it out a bit here for a minute, maybe I can find something cool. Anything cool, such as, like, you know, the exit. What if I just bailed? What if I just let... There's some fish. I'm sure I could find some fish here in this gross-ass part of the lake, right? Right? If I go fishing here, and I learn how to make a rudimentary fire inside my boat... Aha! See? You catch nothing, but there was a bite. You don't know. Maybe there's something. You know, I can work something out. I can work out a way to just kind of, like, survive in the middle of this lake instead of going directly into the horrible hell nightmarescape church. Like, they're telling me keep out, but the game is like, but there is no out. You shall not have an out. Like, how can you expect me to stay out of this goddamn church, buddy? If you're not giving me an option. If you're not giving me a way out. Idiots. Bunch of idiots, these guys. You stay the hell out of our church. You stay the hell out of our church, stranger. But I can't. You sealed all the exits. Get the fuck out of our church, stranger. I'm gonna have to get my mean face on. There's no exit. These exits are painted up. Nope, that's it. I'm getting my impaling, fuck. You brought this on yourself, stranger. We don't like your kind around here. All right, so I look for three heads. I believe that the game is actually telling me, like, I think I saw it in some of the forums around, like, surrounding the game. Like, the idea is I gotta look for three skulls. There is three skulls fucking around the lake here, right? Right? So I need to find a clue as to where I might find said skulls. Where can I find some skulls? Can I get the Black Eye skull? Can I get the I Would Have Been Your Daddy skull? I don't know. Halo Reach came out like a couple of months ago, and I've been playing a lot of Halo. Am I really going to bring up Halo in like a fishing horror game? Maybe I want to a little bit. Maybe I want to talk about it. No, I don't know what else is playing it. To be fair, like, you can find fuck all matches in that game right now. Must be an Australian internet thing. Okay, so I need some kind of clue. Like, I feel like... I mean, I can't just dump my rod anywhere, can I? Can I just dump my rod anywhere? Okay, I'm already lost, by the way. I am absolutely already lost. I have no idea where the hell I am. I kind of just, you know, hit the forward button on my keyboard, and I waited to see what would happen. But I need some sort of clue as to where one might find, you know, a disembodied head. Disembodied skull. Can I just, like, start fishing anywhere? Oh, hey, this looks promising. Hey, look. Not a fucking fan of that noise. That's not a great noise. I'm a fucking fan of that. Eater interact. Oh! I mean, I can see at least one. I can see at least one eye in that thing. Just the one. Hey, maybe I found where those fish eyes went. I did have to find three of those fish. I wonder if that's a plot point. I wonder if, like, the three fish I found that have no eyes. I wonder if that'll be, like, a plot point or something later on. Cool. So I got... horrendous. Disgusting. Maybe that was a sound cue to say, here, the skull's here. The skull... okay, so, like, can I still fish or what? Am I allowed to go fishing? Can I find cool shit? Seems I found no cool shit. Like, I'm sure it's still fairly early in the game, but, like, I'm gonna be bummed out. I think I'm gonna be bummed out if, like, the fishing part of the game was literally just that introduction and nothing else. That'd be the lamest. Like, give me... I require more fishing. I got into this for the fishing components of this game. But yeah, I'm sorry, you know, I missed out on the ability to fish as a child. Because, like, you know, my father didn't spec into that skill tree. So, like, you know, I'm just putting that out there now. All of you expectant fathers out there, all you out there who's like, yeah, I might be a dad someday. No, I'm making it a thing. You have to. You gotta learn to fish now. You don't get that, kid. What the fuck is that? Hey, let's stay the fuck away from that thing. Whoa, okay, screen shaky. Are we done? Okay. So I'm hoping that might be, like, you know, the indicator of some sorts of enemy critter to deal with. Okay, that's not great. That's not great that the game seems to have forgotten about the fishing part. Like, maybe the game will, like, make me fish for one of the skulls or something. That'd be a good way to do it. Like, two of the skulls, I'll, like, just pick them up in the world, but one of them, like, you have to go to a spot and make sure that, like, you know, the spot is marked out or something. The spot very clearly, you fish here, idiot. Look for your heads here. Free heads. You want some heads? Fish here. Dunk your line here. So I see some trees. Cool. I'm mostly wall thugging it in the hope that, like, you know, I will eventually scrape up against the beginning of the level or whatever, like, you know, the next spot that the game wants me to go. I'm hoping those church bells are also saying go this way to get out, to go back to the church area. It seems like, I thought there was a dude standing there. I was kind of hoping there was a dude standing there. I mean, it's just a tree. You know, sometimes you want your jump scares to be like, you know, a bunch of creepy ass villagers watching you, and it turns out it's just a tree. All the best possible spooks just always end up being trees. Yep. Mm-hmm. I don't do a lot of horror games on my channel. Come on, that's gotta be a dude, right? Nah, it's just a bush. It's just a schwabwe. It's just a schwabwe. Mm-hmm. Got a big empty space. A lot of fog. I go fishing here. Something happen if I start going fishing here, maybe? Anything? Not a damn thing. Bummer. Well, that's a bummer, but I'm sure... Oh, here we go. Yeah. Oh, wait, this is the beginning of the level again. Oh. I mean, at least I found it. At least I found the beginning of the level again. That's gotta mean something, right? Can I put the skulls, like, here? Yeah. You don't have the required left eye head to perform the ritual. Okay. Well, what about this one, though? But like, put the skull here. No? So I can only interact with that one, but I don't have the head for it. Maybe it's, I guess programming wise, it's like, you have to do them in sequence instead of like dropping the skulls when you have them. I don't know, video game. I don't know, I haven't been playing the game long enough. All right, so I think that's, I looped around there or some shit, didn't I? So let's, and that's a creepy ass tree. Some mangroves, yeah. Creepy ass mangroves, you don't know, there might be a skull. Maybe people like getting decapitated near creepy ass trees. They're like, you know what, if I'm gonna be a collectible in a horror game, I wanna make sure that you're like, you know, you're gonna kill me in the creepiest goddamn play. I need my death to be as atmospheric as goddamn possible. Do you hear me? You hear me? So I've done my exterior collision. I've gone around the outside of the level, right? So now I'm just kind of barreling immediately forward from the church in hopes that something will happen, right? 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 I mean, this is a big fucking play space. This is huge. Like, you know, I need to feel a good amount of spook. Quit fucking looking at me. I see you looking at me, dickhead. If I go this way, am I just gonna end up back at that pier? I don't wanna end up, like, just back at that pier, right? Right? I mean, I guess those trees are the landmarks. Right? These trees be landmarks. Can I use the trees as a... Like, I could use some kind of landmark. Like, yes, okay, I'm hearing noises, that's good. If I hear the spooky chanting, yeah. Spooky chanting, good. There's something in the water. Yeah. Maneuver the boat a little bit. I can get it. You have a wonderful singing voice, sir. Maybe I can just throw my rod at it. Nah, it's not gonna work. Wait, what was that? You almost got it. Is the game actually telling me? No, you have to chuck a rod at it? Because that's what I wanted. I wanted to have to, like, fish for at least... Yeah, I got it! I just had to be a bit patient. I just had to wait for the head to bite a little bit. Wait, what? Okay, well, whatever. I got that one. Cool! You guys quit fucking looking at me. Awesome, so I've got two of the skulls, and unfortunately, since I don't have the left fucking skull, I can't actually start the horrific ritual. I cannot start the horrific ritual. Okay, so I hugged the wall to the left, and that got me a skull. And then I just kind of bumblefucked, and then, like, leant a little bit to the left, and I got a skull. So, like, in my meats, I feel like if I go this way a little bit, if I push maybe a bit more towards the right, like, you know, level design, game design, like, you know, we would inherently stick everything in, like, a triangle shape. Like, you know, you want your player to explore as much as possible, right? The chimes are that way, and I'm hoping that's, like, again, the game indicator telling me, church, this way. Oh, actually, if anything, I probably shouldn't be going this way then, right? Right? Oh, okay, he's back! No, cut that out. None of that. Ah, fuck me. I should be more careful when wandering around. Oh, no. Oh, fuck, the skulls reset whenever the fish kills you. Shit. That sucks. And I think I actually read on the itch.io page for this game that, like, the monster does get faster the more skulls you collect. I was going in a straight goddamn line. I was going... Ah, come on! No. Okay, not a great start. Not a great start. Can I, like... What do you mean I almost got it? What do you mean I almost got it? Yeah, there's nothing here. I'm throwing my rod on some wood. Video game. My rod on some wood. Alright, so that's gonna be a whole ass thing. The game's gonna reset every time I die, and I'm gonna die more than zero. Great. Alright, I might, for you, the guy in the audience, just like cut or fast forward or something while I collect the skulls that I know where to get, right? Right? I might do that for you. No, come on! No, fuck off! Come on! Come on! Fuck! No, come on! I just saw you! Come on, no, go away! Go away! Scat! Scat! Get lost! Go away! Go annoy someone else! Go away! Okay, cool, we're back here. I was dicking around for 10 minutes, but at least I found this skull again. I need to get a bit of height on this thing. I guess that's close enough, right? Piss off! Come on! No! Bugger off! No, come on, I'm winning! No, that's right! That's right, I'm winning. I'm trying to use these trees as landmarks because they're the only landmarks I've got. The only ones I've got. Like, you know, yeah, it's a horror game. You're supposed to feel spooked. You're supposed to feel like, oh come on! No! No! How? How do I be more careful wandering around? How do I be more careful wandering around, game? How do I do? At least I can find this skull fairly easy now. Like, I've got a... Oh! You bugger off, yo! Piss off! Eat my rod! Eat this rod! Oh my god, can I actually catch it? No, I'm gonna catch this thing now! Catch the fishy! It technically works! It's technically reacting, or it might just be like the game automatically, the almost got it is the line of, no, you failed. Like, no, you didn't almost get it. You almost got nothing. And like, yeah, whenever the fish makes contact with the rod, the game just automatically pulls the rod back in. I guess that's what's happening. Give me this fucking skull. No. It's bullshit that he comes straight, like, head on. Ugh. How do I be more careful, game? God damn. Let me guess, he's gonna fucking come and attack me again, isn't he? Where you at, buddy? I know you're here. Don't you want a piece? Where you at, dickhead? Where you at? Oh shit, he's right behind me! Jesus, he's actually behind me. Fuck. I hear him. I don't see him, and that's quite okay. Oh, there he is! Hey, buddy! Hey! You gonna stop beelining for my boat now? Stop beelining for my boat now, come on! I'm at maximum speed! Yeah, I hear the churning. Oh, yeah, cool, okay, so I just ended up back here, but like, the other way. Cool. Now I just have to... So I got two of the skulls, but I gotta find skull number three on the other side of the goddamn map somewhere. Back at the church, like, come on, like, I don't know, can I, like, leave the skull on the pillar? Can I? There was a part of the village that was always oh, so we unlock lore from doing this. By the river every 4 or 5 years. Why build there if they knew the water would return? But those houses were not inhabited. The rituals required making fake houses with fake straw people and watching them all be claimed by the river. Oh, there's something really funny about that. You're gonna trick the shit out of this river. They're gonna trick the shit out of this natural disaster. The fake village was a symbol for the real one. Each flood started a new cycle to clean the sins of the old population. But were all the dummies in the fake village really made of straw? Their pain feels real to me. Who's talking? Oh! I'm gonna say you're talking. I'm hoping maybe, game, maybe, if I put the skull on the pillar, maybe you'll give me a checkpoint. Maybe. You could give me a little bit of a checkpoint, just a little bit. If the human sacrifices were true, no one alive could confirm a very stormy night. A man was hiking nearby when he saw a disturbing shadow on the path, with a gruesome dark face looking at him. The dark shape released a long wail of agony. It was in fact a haggard and bruised woman wearing a torture mask. What does that look like? A hiker ran scared through the storm, following the path to the nearest city. When he arrived and told the story, people said, "Man, that's stupid. You're a fucking idiot. Shut up, dweeb." No, people wanted to go back and help her, because people are inherently nice. But the storm was too powerful, and when it stopped, the flood had already claimed the village, the path, and all the souls in it. Okay. Okay, so, like, this village is weird, like, river-based BDSM thing. Got caught out by, like, some guy. Some guy accidentally saw one of the gimps running away, and he went, "Oh, shit." Went to tell the cops, and the river was like, "No one can know," and killed everyone in the town. No one can know about our fetish. So now I'm gonna start, like, hugging the right wall, because I hugged the left wall. No! Oh, thank fucking God. Thank fucking God, putting the skulls on the pillar absolutely counts as a checkpoint. Oh, thank Jesus Christ. Are you gonna do this every time? Are you gonna do this every time I go along the right path? Is that what's gonna happen, dickhead? Is that what's gonna happen? Are you just gonna do that every time? Are you just gonna do that every time now? Is backing up the boat faster? If I just, like, hard back up the boat instead of, like, trying to veer off the path, is that faster? This feels faster. I feel like he is, like, kind of catching up on me, but, like, I'm still outpacing him? Maybe? Maybe, game? Maybe? I'm gonna run out of lake in a minute. I came real close to running out of lake there, game. Jesus. What? Oh, fuck off! Okay, I could swear I hear something here. Yeah, the last skull, yeah. Now all I have to do is actually, like, make it back to the church. Yo, get up here, yo, get back here. Yo, got it, yes. All according to plan. Now all I have to do is get back to the fucking church without that big ass fucking fish finding me. Listen for the church, because I could hear the church sirens. Okay, I don't know where I am. I have no idea where I am. Just, like, I'm probably about to eat shit from that fish. I was right. Oh, I hate being right. No, come on, no, I'm backing up. Bullshit. Oh, fuck me. Piss off. Fuck you! Boom! Get down here! Get down here, you little drop! Get you! Got him! Don't got him! Come on! Come on, game! Come on! Piss right off, I will shit in your parents' basement. Piss off. Give me. Thank you. What are you fucking looking at? Run's going good so far. I got the skull. Fish hasn't turned up. I think he was behind me at one point. If he's behind me, that's good. If he's in front of me, then it's just an immediate game over. Just immediately give up. Where did the church go? Come back. You can come back, church. You're allowed to come back. Like, I beelined it to this skull, and then I tried to just, like, backtrack exactly where I was, and then I got lost again. So, like, I could have been done by now? Maybe? I feel like I could have been done by now. 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 Church is going to turn up now. 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 I think if I just keep hugging the wall, like, as close to it as I can get, the fish doesn't have enough room to spawn in. Okay, that's the sound of a fish that is absolutely fucking spawned in. But there's a church! There's a church! There's a church, and the fish is fucked off! The fish is fucked off! The fish is fucked off! We did it! Oh my god, we did it! We did it! We did it! We got the three skulls! We got the three skulls! We got it! We got it! We got it! Preacher Johansson preached about wicked pagan gods in what seemed to be just a rambling speech. He would have been sent to a mental hospital in any other city, but his villagers seemed to find deep meaning in his words. Following him as their spiritual leader made his speech hit a dark and terrible power. Can you hear him talking right now? You want to tell me no, game? You want to tell me no? Okay. Oh, good lord, I should never come here in the first place! But I get it on three hands! This will open a way for me to leave this cursed swamp! That's it. It got me out of the swamp. It got me out of that fucking cursed ass swamp. Awesome! 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 Okay. Okay. That was cool. Segalweet, that's the dude right there. And your friend, Inflatable Platypus. Does he put on a hat and becomes Perry the Inflatable Platypus? That was alright. That was alright. Obviously, at a certain point, the fish stops being scary and it just starts being really fucking aggravating. Like, that fish is some absolute goddamn bullshit. That fish is some absolute fucking bullshit. But, like, I feel like there's some things I, like, want to say to impress, to, like, improve the game, but it's, like, any of those suggestions I would make would, like, make it less of a horror game. Like, I was like, you know, maybe we could use some more landmarks, although the trees were kind of landmarks. So I guess those, like, dead-ass trees are fine. Yeah, that's right. It was only made, like, this month. Like, yeah, I think it only came out, like, less than a week ago. And I'm going to try and get this video out, like, as soon as possible. For them YouTube creds. You know? But yeah, that was fun. That was fun. Sometimes you just need a really weird-ass goddamn concept. Like, you know, what if we slap fishing and horror together? What if we slap cooking and NASCAR racing together? Maybe. You don't know. It could work. If this game can happen, then anything could happen. And if I go escape, yeah, it just takes me straight back to the beginning of the level. Yeah, cool. So yeah, that was Rottonwood Lake. It's on itch.io. I believe it's like a pay what you want sort of deal. So yeah, just go give this game a poke. Go give this game a poke. It's interesting. It'll get frustrating as fuck after a minute. But you know, for those first 20 minutes, it was really cool. It was really interesting. That was worth it. That was cool. That was something cool. I want to go murder some fish now.